All right, let's see. Yeah, I think I have to keep that. Okay, that got a lot better. But we're still needing to top deck here. And at least he didn't have Farika's cure this time. Jeez, nothing? Okay, I'll take Springleaf Drum. I will take it. So I can go ahead and cast a Wingsteed Rider here. Shredding Winds. Walked right into it. Every time. Okay, no attacking. So with 4 mana, all I can do is play the Emissary, which is perfectly fine. Yeah, that's fine. We can actually get aggressive here pretty soon. Man, he slams those things so fast. Right, so much for being aggressive. Well, we could play the All Seed on the Hoplite. So we'd have a 5/5 and then a 3/3. Tapping Black Oak, I guess. It's the same thing either way, whatever. He would take 5 damage. I think. Well, no, I can't do that anyway. I have to use the drum to cast it, so I would just attack for 5, and he'd probably take it. So it's the same thing. But I'm just going to cast Sphinx's Disciple, actually. I feel like he's slow enough that we are just gonna start grinding him out with card advantage. And I think we'll be aggressive too, if we want to. Just depends what he does here. He does have double sip. Oh, and a Lash of the Whip. All right, well, a Pharah, that'll do it. Let's see. Oh, we can actually Vortex, tapping Vortex. Oh, well, I don't know why I'm doing this pre-combat. I'm gonna cast a Pharah. I'm doing it pre-combat for no reason. I am gonna, in fact, get in for 2 damage here. And if he has that card minus one, I just got super punished. I should have just cast the Pharah. Okay. Don't know why he would have that card, but it's always possible. Okay, now let's get this down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One more. Yeah, he's dead. He is just so dead. So let's see. We only have 5 mana right now. Oh no! At least I got a card out of it. But jeez, he got me so good. Wow. I wonder if he even had that before, because he could have cast it on the Heliod's Emissary. I don't know. Maybe he just didn't have a chance to cast it on it yet. Attacking. How does that make sense? Doesn't seem to make any sense. I think we're just gonna enchant this at this point. The fact that he attacked makes me think he has Savage Surge, and then I would lose my emissary if he did. But I think that's fine. I think I'll have to accept that possibility. Okay, cool. Yeah, I don't know. He just wanted to attack. I mean, he could have the other Grey Merchant. He could just think down the line he's only going to win if he can Grey Merchant and Mox's Marauder me out. And I guess I really wasn't applying that much pressure. Casting Baleful Eidolon. And then follow up with the Grey Merchant. Okay. Okay, that'll make things pretty interesting, actually. We're a long way from winning this game, even though we are very far ahead. Okay, well, that's a lot of insurance right there. Let's say I attack with... I can't attack with the emissary, because it just gets teamed up on. And then if I attack with this, the Eidolon will take it out. Using Vortex Elemental on the Eidolon would cost me a lot this turn. I am just going to actually cast Deepwater Hypnotist and Traveling Philosopher, and then I'm going to use the Hypnotist to make the Eidolon irrelevant next turn. Then I have to start worrying about the oak. Okay. Okay, so we tap the oak. Now we still can't attack with that emissary. So the oak can be a 3/8, more than big enough to block this. Yeah, we're just stuck. I still don't want to use the Vortex Elemental. It taps me out, so I can't God's Willing. I'm just going to cast Wingsteed Rider and pass. He's still got one card. He's gonna go ahead and attack. I don't know if that's a good idea. I'll trade my Traveling Philosopher for that card. Okay. Okay, now that we drew a land, we can Vortex the Oak, tap a Grey Merchant, and, well, this one still gets blocked by the Grey Merchant, so I guess I'm just killing the Oak, and then attacking for 2, and 5. Just one card in hand. Getting in. Okay, I think we're doing just fine. 2, 4, 6, 7. I also need to be aware of Mox's Marauder. The only way I could have like made an attempt to play around that really is by vortexing the merchant to to get power off the board, but... Oh no, he's blocking with Grey Merchant. But, that would just give him his Grey Merchant back into his library, and that's just as bad, I think. So, I think this is the best I could do. And since he blocked the Grey Merchant, that would indicate a raised dead effect, even though in game two he conceded when a raised dead effect could have possibly won in the game still. That is the only creature in his graveyard, though, at this point. So, or he has something else. What is this? Rescue from the Underworld. I'm dead. He did erase that effect. And wow, was it a good one. I'm not dead, though. Am I dead? We'll find out. I'm not entirely sure the way that card works, so... If they both come back at the same time, they do, it looks like. So I'm taking 10. Alright, I'm dead. Wow. Well, I feel like I couldn't have played around that. I mean, if I knew he had it, I would have obviously attacked for two every turn. But as soon as one Grey Merchant dies, I lose. And that's really hard to predict and to play around. Alright, we went 1-1. I feel like I should have won that game, but... Thanks for watching, guys.